So today we are going to discuss about Power App for SharePoint. But if you are new to Power App and you want to learn what is Power App and why do you need Power App, then do watch our first video on the intro of Power App, the link for which I'll provide in the top section over here, or you can go to the description section to find that link. But if you are interested to directly go into the demo, then continue watching this video. So I've connected to Office 365 where I've opened my SharePoint online site containing this list called Traveler App. I'm going to use this list to create the Power App. So if you want to use the same list, I will provide the link to the Excel file where I have this data. You can just fill up your list with this same data that I have filled over here. Now to create Power App, first let us open the Power App site. If you are coming for the first time, then you need to try for free. So you can click on this button over here to start free. And if you already have an account, just click on the sign in button on the right hand side. And once you click the sign in button, it will log you in into your Power App portal. Over here, if you see, there are different ways to create Power Apps, which I discussed in my previous video as well. But if you see, there are, you can create apps from Canvas app, which is you can start from the very blank. You can use a model driven approach to create an app, which is the second option over here, or you can start from an existing data source. So last time I used Excel as my data source, if you watch my previous video. But in this one, I am connecting to the SharePoint list, which I just showed over here. So I have to connect to this particular list. So to do that, you just need to click on this connect to SharePoint data source, this SharePoint icon. Over here, you need to choose whether it is a cloud service or whether it you are connecting to the on-premises data gateway. Because I'm using Office 365, so I will connect directly to the cloud service and I will click the create button over here. So once it connects to the data source, you will see the connection on the left hand side. If you have existing connections as well, that will also get displayed with it. After that, you just need to provide the name of the SharePoint site, which you can get by just copying everything before the list word. So this is the SharePoint URL. So I can get that thing and I will provide the name of the SharePoint site, which once you click on Glow, it will show you all the different lists that are available under this particular site, and you can choose that particular list from here. Once you select that Traveler app, which our Power App is going to connect to for its data source, click on the connect button, then Power App will use the CRUD operation to create all the different views of that particular list. So it will create the view option, it will create the delete option, it will create the read option, and it will create the edit option. So if you click on the browse screen where you can see all the items under one single view, so you will see the different items that we have on the list, that SharePoint list, that are getting displayed like an app interface. Then you have a detail screen where you will see the that particular single item in a detail. So you will see a lot of other things on this particular view. Then there is an edit screen where if you want to edit a particular item. Now let me show you this app. So you click on the right, go in the right hand side, there is a preview this app button. Click on that button, you will see this app. You can go ahead and delete a particular item. You can edit this particular item. If you want to edit, then this is the edit screen. So if you want to cancel the changes or you want to append the changes, you can do that. So this is how the preview of the app looks like. So now there is absolutely zero code that we have written till now, and it looks amazing how beautiful this app has come out. There, by default, it will also provide you sort feature. It will also provide you search feature. So these all features are provided by default. You can do change these features by yourself. So right now, if you see the sorting is happening on this name of the hotel. So if, for example, you want to sort on some other field, you can do change that. Right now, you can also search what you want. So if, for example, if I type something 460, it's not searching because it's not searching, I guess, on that. So if you say base, so it see it got searched. So depending upon how the search is set up, you can do change that search parameters or the sort parameters. And we'll see how do we do that. Now, first thing that we want to show you is how do you change the layout of your app. So right now, this layout looks perfect. But even if it looks perfect and I want to see how to change the layout, just click on the app as a whole, or click on the browse gallery over here on the left hand side. Then if you go on to the right hand side, the gallery view over here, you will see that there is a layout option over here. So this layout option, you will see that there are different options that you can choose. There are different options to choose from, and right now the option that is selected is this one with image, title, subtitle and body. For my case, this one is okay, but if you want, you can change that option as well. So that's the layout part. What else? Now if you want to, other than the layout, if you want to change the fields that are getting populated on the browse screen, maybe you don't want this thing over here. Definitely I don't want this 3486, this is the itinerary number. So I don't want this itinerary number. So what you can do is you click on this browse gallery again on the first card that you see over here right now. And if you see on the right hand side, you will see the word called fields. You can click on this, edit this, and you will see that you can choose the field that you want to opt for. Right now the second one is itinerary number. Instead of itinerary number, I want the country where this hotel is. Plus on the third one is the address. Instead of address, I want the price, for example. So price of the hotel. So I can just select the price column and that's it. So the price also has been selected. So now let me show you how the sort and search option works. So currently if you click on the sort part, so if you click on the sort button over here, it doesn't do much. So basically what it says is that it will update the context of whatever it is doing right now to a negate of that. Means if right now it is doing ascending, if string from top to bottom or ascending order, it will start doing descending. So it's just trying to do the negate of what it is being done. So it's just triggers the negation part. But the actual sorting and updating happens with this code. So if you click on the card, the whole card again, you will see that it tells you something about the filtering part as well, where you do the search of the item, plus it tells you something about sorting. So if I expand this section, so if you see over here right now, it is sort by column. So there are three things that are written. So if you understand sort by column, it works in this way. First option is that it tells that it has to sort also on this particular item, but majorly when you think about sorting, you will talk about this middle option. Right now it is sorting on the title, which is this hotel name over here. But if you want to, for example, sort on the country name, so what I can do is, instead of title, I can just say country. So it will start sorting on the country parameter. So let me show you how. So if I click again on the right hand side, preview this app feature, and if you sort now, so you will see that it is sorting now on the country. So see, Amsterdam comes up first, then the Doha, then Paris, and then Switzerland, and then Vienna. So it's sorting now based on the country parameter. So that's how easy it is to change the sort parameter. Now if I want to do the filtering change, so right now if you see that the filtering starts with title. And now if I want to change the filtering option as well, so for that also you just need to change the thing from title to start with country, and that should do the trick. So if I now again run this or preview this app, and if I type the hotel name now, see, it will not search that particular thing. Now if I type A, so it will tell you all the hotels that are with Amsterdam. So that's how you can change the filtering and the sorting parameter. That's easy it is to change that. Now the other thing that you would have noticed, if I run this app and if I go to view details, maybe there are cases where you don't want all these items to be displayed, or maybe you don't want the price to be at the very bottom. You definitely need price at the top. So how do you change these all things? Very easy. Go back to your app, go into, instead of the browse gallery option, just click on the detail screen option, and in the detail screen option, if you see right now, click on the detail form over here, and if I click on the edit fields, so what I can do is I can move the fields over here. So right now if you see, I can add fields, you can even add some more fields from the SharePoint list onto this particular place, or you can move things. I want the price to be just below the title, maybe, for example. And if I don't need the itinerary number to be displayed, so I can just remove the itinerary number. And for example, I just don't need the country name over here, so I can remove the country name as well. So that's how easy it is to change the fields. And now if you run this app, you will see that it has changed itself. So title comes on the top with price, then the address and the hotel peak and the start and the end date. So now if you want to add some more text over here to just to for information purposes, you can do that. Now I can change the how the data gets get displayed on the browse section. I can just move things around, and even I can insert new things. Like for example, if I want to insert a new label, I can do insert that. So right now it is showing the name of the country, but I can change that. So if I go to this, it's showing this item.country on the text field. Instead, you just inside the quote, you can type any text. So right now I will say price. And when I say price, it will be getting displayed over here. So when you are doing these things inside the card, you will notice that it will do it for all the different cards that you have on, or the different items that are there. So now the price word is too big, so I can just make it as 15 maybe. Okay, and I can just make it as bold. So these are the formatting that you can do. This is a little bit very away from here. So now it tells you the price of this particular hotel correctly. So now if you want to do some kind of conditional formatting, maybe when the price is of a hotel is above 100, you want to show a particular color, and if it is above 230, you want to do something different. So you can do conditional formatting onto your particular item. Click on an item on which you want to do the conditional formatting on. So for example, I am selecting the price field. So if you notice that any selecting any particular item, it says this item.price. Similarly for country, it will say this item.country. So this item is a very important keyword over here, and it is being used in a lot of different places. So and we will be using it a lot. So now if you want to change the color, coming back to it, if you want to change the color, do a conditional formatting on this item, what I can do is I can go to the color section over here. So where is the color section? So if you go on the top, maybe, so this is the color section. Right now it's a single color, which is the black color that you see. But if I want to do a conditional formatting, I can do that. For example, I have this code that I have written. I am just, so if this item dot price means the price item is greater than 200, just show the color red, and else you will do this formatting. So multiple if conditions are there. So over here inside that, if it is false, there is another if condition which says that if this item dot price is greater than 100, then, and it is less than 200, then you have to make it as blue, or else you can make it as green. So this is the conditional formatting. Now if you see, and if I run this app, you will see that this is 150, this is 230. So 230 is made into red, while the other ones are made into green, and this one is into blue. So that's how you do the conditional formatting. So the next thing that you will see is, how do we know whether a particular item is selected or not? So if you run the app right now, you will not know which item is selected. So if I'm on this particular item, Doha Intercontinental, I don't know which item is selected right now. So how do you know that? For that, we kind of add a particular item over here, a highlighter, which will let you know which particular item is selected. So select the card over here, we're gonna add the highlighter to, and then you can basically click on this plus icon and click on this rectangle. You can search for this rectangle thing, drop this rectangle over here. So once you drop the rectangle inside a particular section, it will see, it will get added to all the different sections over there. So then you just make a small thin highlighter at the corner. You can make it more thin by changing the width over here. I will just make it as 12, for example. Right now it is available for all the item. How do I make sure that it is available only for a selected item? So just click on that, and for the visible property, right now it is set to true. So instead of making it true, I will this item is selected. So if this item dot is selected returns a boolean value whether this particular item is selected or not selected, and based on the boolean value the visible property will be set to true and false. That's how you do this. And right now if you see that this item is selected Intercontinental Doha, so it's by default showing you that particular item getting selected. So now if I click on this item, this one item gets selected. Now if I choose the base cafe, so the base cafe is the one that is selected. So I hope you would have loved this video and you would have learned something from here. So this was the first part of a video where we worked our way to connect our data source on SharePoint list and how we can work with that data source with various different options, from sorting, from searching, and then how do you change or move the items on the different views that we have, where we had the browse screen view, where we have the edit screen view and the details view. So we can do all sort of things, connect to different items, remove items from that particular screens. So that all things you can do. Do let me know if you have any questions in the comment section below. Do like and subscribe our channel, Help Me Coder, and until next time, happy coding.